بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم أما بعد طيب اليوم نحن ندرس عن التنوين okay we will study about تنوين okay what's a big deal about تنوين really not much except for the writing rules
okay
yeah so we have three تنوين in Arabic right we have فتحتان That comes okay. That's not fatha, but two of them, kasratan
and dhammatan.
Okay. So don't worry about the actual writing style. So in the mushaf, sometimes you'll find tanween, especially the dhammatan, written in various ways. But know that it is two dhammas and two fathas and two kasras. Okay. What's the special rule about the writing rule? We will find out inshallah okay so let's certain some examples qitarun okay ma mana qitarun
qitarun
yeah umar got qitar from his brother train okay qitarun notice how dhammatan is right it just you just write dhammatan like that and then
sunduk
box sundukun and I want you to observe the dhammatan at the end of the word okay sundukun
everyone has
dhammatan I'm going to yeah that's okay just hang on just follow along la'batun what is la'batun
toy
very good samakatun
samakatun is fish
very easy
masa'un
okay so we don't find anything special over here right we just see dhammatan at the end and there's nothing really special about it okay so which is cool no problems now look at kasratan how kitarin okay in now sometimes it is kitarun sometimes it is kitarin sometimes it is kitaran why that's a grammar rule we're not talking about the grammar rules right now we are only talking about how the tanween or tanween is actually written okay there are some exceptions and I want you guys to get a good hang of this writing rule and it helps a lot in reading as well in understanding as well later on inshallah okay right now just focus on the rules of writing it okay
okay
look at this
sunduqin
okay you would say fi sunduqin
la'batin
okay and then we have samakatin
masa'in
okay still no nothing complicated everything is just simple you write kasratan all at the bottom okay now here is the exception is in fathatan when you have fathatan at the end there is a rule what do you find here Abdullah
kitaran
now but what do you find there's a special there's something different from this from the other ones there's an alif right
yeah.
So you don't find that in the other dhammatan and kasratan but in fathatan you must write an extra alif you don't read that except when you stop otherwise you do not read it you actually read it as kitaran the alif is only for writing okay and when you stop you say kitara
that's why it is
yeah okay so let's look at this sunduqan notice again how there's an extra alif we don't read it unless we stop on it we say sunduqa okay la'batan now notice the difference
la'batan there is no
because
it's a
so the rule is that if you have ta marbuta and if you have fathatan then it is just normal there is no
there's technically the so the
ha sound yeah exactly you're right we say lo'ba
the alif
so stop on it you say lo'ba
the alif is hiding behind the fathatan
no there's no alif when you have fathatan there is no alif
it's hidden
no we say there's no alif
there's no alif
at all okay now notice samakatan again there is no extra alif okay
it's just
fathatan on ta marbuta now notice masa'an
is hamza
now here the rule is that if you have Alif, and then followed by Hamza, and then you have Fathatan like this. You do not write extra Alif. What do the Arabs say? The Arabs say that if you write Alif here and then another Alif here, it looks ugly. So they say, if you have Alif and then Hamza and then you have Fathatan, you don't write it. Okay, so the rule then is that in all of this, you don't write extra Alif except when you have Fathatan and other than Ta Marbuta and Hamza Alif followed by Hamza. If you have these two, if you have Fathatan without these, without the Ta Marbuta or without the Alif and the followed by Hamza, only then you write this extra Alif. Okay? Is that clear?
Yeah.
I want you to learn this very early. Okay? So you can, and I'll tell you how beautifully it all ties into the grammar rules later on. Okay? Tayyib. Let's do a quick activity. Okay? Now I want you to pay attention. If you get something wrong, something will pop out and will scare you. Okay? Don't get anything wrong. So is it clear? Do you want me to repeat anything? Is it? Okay? You understood, right? Tayyib. Okay, select the word that is written incorrectly. Yes, you survived. You survived, man. Okay, one more. Okay, that was the right answer. Okay. Now, select the word that is written correctly. That's not correct, man.
No!
Yeah, why is that correct?
Oh, because it has a...
Yeah, because what did I tell? The extra alif...
Oh, because it's done like that!
Yeah, remember, the extra alif is only when you have tanween, fathatan, okay? This one over here. Only when you have fathatan, and there's no Ta Marbuta or Hamza, then only you have to write extra alif. Notice here, this Kasra Ta.
Oh!
Okay, so therefore this extra alif is not needed.
But you never taught me that grammar rule.
I told you, man.
Did?
Yeah.
Oh.
So now, if you have Damatan as well, you will not write. Okay?
Okay.
Thank you. Okay, so those were the rules of writing Fathatan. Okay? And Kasratan and Dhammatan. Okay, and inshallah, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Bye, guys. Please remember to like and subscribe. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section down below. Bye.